tragedies that we've turned into triumphs, their struggles that we've turned into sisterhood, into glorious moments, into achievement. And it's just a different way to look at things that for me has been really fire and fuel and food and fortifying, and I just wanted to share that with you. It's beautiful to know that the museum folks recognize the power of film within the idea, the power of images within the idea. We've seen throughout history images be used and twisted and distorted. We've seen the power of film as it's been taken into our culture and used against what is good, whether it's the birth of a nation, whether it's the film of birth of a nation, about 100 years ago, that was a real distortion of who black people were, and that those images really embedded themselves in the culture at the time, and the residue of that is the things that we're still feeling. Or whether it's news coverage of uprisings and political outbursts that are termed riots and that are misrepresented in the way that they're covered. Images have power, and I feel like film is a part of that. So I thank the museum for recognizing that power, and I'll tell you one last story. Feeling very overwhelmed being here with my fellow honorees, feeling very unworthy of it, and was trying to just reflect on the award being encouragement to me as I go forward. Really, I don't receive it as achievement. I receive it as encouragement. And a few hours ago, another piece of encouragement came that I wanted to share with you that really solidifies this idea of the power of film. So before Selma, I made a film for very little money called Middle of Nowhere. The Middle of Nowhere was the film for which my team and I won an award at the Sundance Film Festival, which is considered a really big deal in the film world. That film was about a woman dealing with her loved one who was incarcerated. And through the film, I tried to show a microcosm, a small slice of life of the loved ones of the incarcerated. We have 2.2 million people behind bars in this country, the majority of which are black men. When you think about their families and their children, when you think about the trials and tribulations that those families go through to stay connected, it's really a crime. That's a crime. And so within that, within the film, we show her challenge in keeping in touch with her loved one, with her husband. And one of those challenges is phone calls. The predatory phone rates, private companies that are preying on families who are just trying to stay connected to their loved ones, just trying to make a call. In some states, almost $12 a minute. $12 a minute? $12 a minute is over 2 minutes. I'm spending $24 to speak and to keep in touch. Challenging, challenging. And so a group of people, in illustrating the power of film, a group of activists were working with the FCC for years to try to get these predatory phone rates regulated through the FCC. It fell on deaf ears. Then one day, there was a turn of events in the FCC, and a woman named Mignana Clyburn was given a very temporary FCC chairwomanship. They said, you can be in for this amount of time while we find the next person. And during that time, that sister did some work. Ourselves and the way that we are seen. And I thank you for seeing me. I thank you for seeing my film.